You told the BBC recently the rich were responsible for this crisis, the blue-eyed bankers. You weren't going to allow them to blame the poor of the world. What did you mean? Doesn't everybody blame the bankers no matter what their eye color?
I'm married with a woman that has blonde hair and blue eyes. Well, the problem is that when I gave this interview, I was with Gordon Brown. He was in Brazil. And there was a persecution going on to the immigrants, especially in Europe. The blacks in Europe, the Latinos. And I said very clearly, the crisis was caused not by blacks or by Latinos. That crisis was caused by the bankers that have blue eyes.
So you wanted to make sure that there wasn't a conflation or mistake that people say, hey, let's keep out the immigrants because we're having economic trouble because it wasn't their fault. That was your point?
Yes, that was my point, because it's a false idea or concept that when there's a crisis pop up, you put the blame on the immigrants and you play the immigrants against the people of that country where they are. The reply that I gave in Brazil was to legalize all the foreign undocumented living in Brazil to prove that it was not the immigrants' fault. They were not the ones to be responsible for the crisis.
Does the prominence of this G20 meeting mean that emerging economies like Brazil's are finally getting their due?
Well, I believe that it is very difficult in the world of today for you to continue with G8 only without taking into account the importance of Brazil, China, India, mainly in the world economy, because we are great consumers, large consumers, and we're also becoming great producers, and also because we were better prepared than the rich countries for this crisis. This is the first global crisis that it doesn't start in poor countries, and it was caused by the rich countries and the institutions like IMF, World Bank, that knew supposedly everything when the crisis happened in Brazil, in countries like Brazil. Now they don't know nothing when the crisis happened in the U.S. And so it's necessary for us to take advantage of this crisis and do things the right way. To have the financial system has to be regulated. We have to end with the tax havens. And it's necessary that the central banks in the world should control a little bit the banks' financing, because they cannot bypass a certain range of leverage. And so I believe that today, if you want me to be sincere, I believe that there's no other more any reason for a G8 group or any other G. I believe that we should guarantee that the G20 should be now an important forum to discuss the major economic issues of the world.